And here he is. And the mastermind's works up. I think people that like these systems must like RVs too. These look really nice. Are these, this is this six pack for me or for someone else?
That's your six pack.
Nice. So this is going in the RV. Man, you did it right. You did it exactly like in the book.
Everything that's inside is either Lexan, some form of plastic, or stainless steel. There's nothing in there that can rust. This little time-consuming part of the endeavor here is what really gets you. See, you can buy all the parts, and you can pile them in a box, and they don't cost a great deal. Probably under $100 altogether, maybe. But when you start factoring in all the little manpower hours, let's grab one. I'll show you how I put these together.
This is so great. Thank you. This is going to be fun. My stepdad's really good at this stuff.
Mm-hmm. Or
he's pretty good at mechanics, and he's interested to see this. And he's like, "You're really going by the guy's house?" And I was like, "Well, yeah, he's here in Dallas, and I'm going to Houston, so... If we put that six pack in there, man, and it, I've been getting 7.5 miles to the gallon.
There she goes. But when they come undone like that, they start wrapping up, they're a little bit harder to work with.
Oh, because you've already wound them once.
Power, mm-hmm. These things start bubbling. The little bitty bubbles are the hydrogen. The bigger bubbles are oxygen. And they start to float to the surface. And they push out air, because it's got nowhere to go but out. So they start pushing out the air, immediately start pushing everything out of here, and then here comes the hydrogen, here comes the oxygen. And it's not long before this is all hydrogen in here. You're taking something that's wasted, basically, to me. If your engine's running and your alternator's pumping out energy, but you've got a voltage regulator on there because you really don't need all that to charge your battery after you're driving down the road for a while. You really don't need all that energy. When you start using that energy that you've been wasting all this time for a purpose like that, and it's so easy to make, it's so easy to separate the hydrogen and the oxygen. If I touch these two guys together, they're grounded together. And these, see, and this. But if I touch this to this, it may not work, see? Until we get the batteries hooked up. Yeah. When we get the batteries hooked up, if I did like that, yeah, they would work. See, this side, these four cells are separate from those four, both ground and relay. They got their own, these got their own set of grounds and their own relay and their own power. These have their own power, ground, relay. Okay.
Green Earth Help Place.
Green Earth Help Place that installed and created the electrolyzers. So this is really their creation, but my baby.
The mothership.
The mothership
is ready to roll.
You can see the bubbles?
Oh yeah.
Ooh, yeah,
looks like straight out of the X-Files.
I think I'm going to switch one out once in a while, put some plates in. I'm going to have to videotape when it starts out clear how fast it starts to bubble.
Yeah.
Because we just turned this on, like, I should have been recording when we turned on the RV. Because I ran inside and now they're murky. So you can't see through them. I mean, they were like this. 20 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds ago, half a minute ago now.
Very first
hybrid RV.
This is the coolest thing. No one has anything like this. We're rolling with hydrogen now, baby.
There you go. That is it.